Hi, Leo. Welcome to Tarot Readings by Roxby. I am going to do your December general monthly for December 2016. My new subscribers, welcome. Thank you guys so much for taking the time to subscribe to the channel. So for my new subscribers especially, let me say that if this reading does not resonate with you, please look at your moon, your rising sign. Also, there is no gender, man, woman, you know, whoever it is for you. Private readings, absolutely, it matters. General, definitely not. Those of you that would like a private reading with me, my contact info will be below the video. So I'll have a link to my Facebook page. I do share a lot of stuff on my page. I run contests, I'm actually running one now. I do free readings. I do interact a lot. So anybody want to check it out? Awesome. Okay, so I have already prayed over the cards and I did shuffle. And, you know, I prayed for love, wealth, health, happiness, for miracles. You know, miracles are known to be given in December. Good. Okay, we are going to do the Celtic cross spread. Same as always. Okay, Leo. Well, we start out with the Ten of Cups. Nice. Crossed by the Five of Swords, and you're crossing you, challenging you. Okay, in the foundation, we have the Queen of Wands. In the recent past, we have the Eight of Cups. Moving into the present, we have the Nine of Pentacles. Moving into the future, Major Arcana, the Lovers. Major Arcana cards, highly spiritual cards, universe speaking to you strongly through these cards, trying to tell you something, promote something, make you aware of something within your life. How you see yourself is the Knight of Cups. In your environment and people around you, we have the Five of Wands. In your hopes and fears, the Four of Pentacles. And the outcome is the Hierophant, Major Arcana. I'm going to pull another card on that. And the Ten of Pentacles. Okay, so those two, okay, not that we're going to use it, but that is what's at the bottom of the deck. Page of Cups, maybe a new love offering, Scorpio, Pisces, Cancer. Okay, so you know, I not to jump right to the end, but like I see it, even with the Four of Pentacles, that you know, saving, conserving, you know, all right. I mean, we're definitely going to clarify a couple cards. I could definitely see that, you know, because, you know, right in the center, you know, with the Ten of Cups and the Five of Swords. You know, this is definitely being in a hostile environment. Okay. You know, your current card and your challenging card. You know, it's conflict. You know, it's choosing the battle. You know, it's a hostile environment, okay? You know, but yeah, with the Lover's card here, you know, in your future and the Hierophant, you know, that's personal beliefs. And all right, so in the foundation, we have the Queen of Wands, okay? Aries, definitely your element, you know, always attractive. You know, I mean, it doesn't have to be, but, you know, it could be somebody new, maybe, coming in. Or maybe someone that you left. Let me say this too. Whatever I say, you know, could go either or. If it's not you, then it would be somebody else. I mean, this is definitely a love reading. That there's no doubt about it. All right, so the Queen of Wands. You know, always attractive, good looking, warm, smile. She's energetic, cheerful. You know, I just feel like this is definitely you guys. You like your energy for sure. You know, with the Eight of Cups being here. You know, some of you could be, you know, lacking energy. You don't want to deal with it anymore. You know, with the Eight of Cups here, you know, Scorpio, Pisces, Cancer, usually Scorpio, but Sun, Moon, or Rising. You know, you don't want to deal with it anymore, so you left. You know, or, you know, you left the situation emotionally. You left what no longer serves you. You know, in the Nine of Pentacles, you know, Virgo, but Taurus, Capricorn, again, Sun, Moon, Rising. You know, you're showing restraint, self-control. You're working hard. You know, you're moving in the direction of your goal. You know, luxury living. You know, and the Lovers too, even with the Ten of Pentacles, you know, that's permanent unions, that's family ties. You know, with the Ten of Cups, that's also bonding too. All right, so you see yourself as the Knight of Cups, right? So, again, you know, water, Scorpio, Pisces, Cancer. You know, some of you could be expressing your feelings, trying to make, you know, the most practical choice. You know, or if you're moving towards this energy or vice versa, it could be a romantic partner. You know, he would definitely be, or she, again, no gender, you know, sensitive, you know, romantic, you know, just romantic enough to remember special occasions. So that's how you see yourselves. which is beautiful. You know, with the fire, you know, this is your environment and people around you, and this is what's crossing you and challenging you. So I feel like there's people set up, like, against you. Which is very, very possible. You know, like people set up against each other. There's discord. You know, because in your environment, there's disagreements, hassles, quarrels, arguments. With the Five of Swords, that's, you know, people set up, like, against each other. Leo, what is going on? You know, then with the Four of Pentacles and your hopes and fears, you know, again, I said it before, it's, I feel like it's, you know, you're making sure that you have enough. Maybe some of you are holding on to, you know, a relationship, you know, tightly, way too strongly. You know, the Lovers, you know, in the being in the future, this is, you know, decisions. You know, in this deck, you know, these two are soulmates. You know, notice there's nobody in the middle of them with this deck. You know, with it totally represents love. Hierophant and the Ten of Pentacles. You know, that's, again, being conservative. Following the rules, too. You know, with the Four of Pentacles, it's, like, it's with the Four of Pentacles, as with all that, you know, it shows you in a possessiveness, you know, in a control. I see it here and here. Okay. So we're definitely going to clarify the Lovers and see what that's all about first. Spirit for Leo. Why is the Lovers in the future position for Leo? December. Actually feels good. Right, the Six of Pentacles, Ace of Wands, and the Ace of Pentacles. Well, so there's definitely abundance, there's passion. Gifts, you worked hard to save the relationship. you know, you're making the effort, you know, definitely. You know, with the Ace of Wands, you know, inventing a better way, coming up with the solution, expressing yourself, giving 110%. Let's look at the Eight of Cups. Okay. We have the Death card on the Eight of Cups with the Five of Cups. Goodbye. You're gone. Definitely over. Definitely the Death card is in reverse. I am so sorry. You know, this, I don't usually have reversals. I mean, those of you that have been following me, you know, from the very beginning, you know, I do cleanse my deck a lot. So, you know, having a reversal is unusual. You know, definitely for some of you, you know, it could be an ending, could be over. But this being in reverse, you know, it could be, you know, you could possibly be approaching an ending, you know, just a temporary parting of ways. You know, so anything like that just could be coming up for some of you. And then for others of you, definitely, probably an ending, a loss. You know, there's two fives in this reading, and fives are, you know, change, challenge, loss, conflict, chaos. You know, but also opportunity. You know, I feel like for some of you, it's something that you possibly want, but then there's others of you that are desperately making the effort to make this work. But yet still, let's look at the outcome card. Well, I already have. Let's see. I can only pull one more on the outcome card. Right, let's look at Four of Pentacles first. All right, well, Justice fell out. All right, so you guys want what's fair. Do the right thing. That's what you're hoping is happening, is going to happen. You know, being right under the Ten of Pentacles, it could be legal issues for some of you. Right down to a divorce. And on the outcome card is the King of Pentacles. Some of you could be ending a, you know, leaving a relationship for an earth sign. You know, some of you are going to definitely keep your commitment. You know, this is not going to happen, this ending. I can't, I'm so glad I realized that. Like I said, I cleanse my decks all the time. So have a reversal is rare for me. But with justice, you know what? Doing what needs to be done. You know, for the rest of you, your commitment, you know, that it could definitely be fixed in your relationship for sure. I definitely, you know, if that relationship did end, you know, when they already left. You know, I'm a day late. I mean, but not, you know, maybe, you know, possible they could be coming back. Let's see what your overall guidance. And I'm sorry, I forgot to mention too that I am using the Gilda Tarot and messages from your angels by Doreen Virtue. I'm going to pull just an overall guidance card on the reading. Let's see what comes up. For Leo Spirit, overall guidance on this reading for December 2016 for Leo. Okay, well, this card fell up, so I guess it's going to be this one. Archangel Michael, I am with you, giving you the courage to make life changes that will help you work on your divine life's purpose. That's just beautiful. Yep, courage. And you will. I hope before Christmas for you guys. I mean, seeing this more the third, fourth week, we're balancing out just, you know, whatever it is for you, whatever's going to happen. But, you know, definitely, you know, if you are leaving, you know, this toxic relationship, you know, you're moving towards someone who's grounded, secure, stable, honest, generous, just a nice guy, earth sign, Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn. Usually well off. Handy, you know, he's jack of all trades. You know, the Hierophant, the Lovers, you know, definitely. Could represent a married couple. But I do feel really strongly that a lot of you have a very good chance of saving this. You could definitely fix this, without a doubt. Without a doubt, Leo. Thank you guys so much for taking the time to view the video. I hope this reading helps you guys out. If not, you know, if it didn't resonate, definitely, you know, take from this reading what you can, what resonates, leave what doesn't. Look at your moon, your rising sign. But overall, I mean, it's positive. You know, I mean, it seems to be what a lot of you want to. So really, make it a great month, and I will see you guys back here with the morning oracle cards. Bye-bye.